Hey everyone, welcome to today's video. If you want to quickly set up your own task management system from scratch, but don't know where to start, this video is perfect for you. Especially for beginners just getting into TickTick, this will be a complete beginner's guide. I'll walk you through four simple steps to set up an efficient task management system. Let's dive in. When you first open TickTick, let's start with the inbox. Go to the inbox and type in everything you need to do. If you're on mobile, tap the plus sign at the bottom right to add a task. Whether it's something personal like exercise, pay credit card bill, or attend music festival, or work tasks like plan feature launch, or reply customer messages, just throw it all into the inbox. Wondering what the inbox is? Think of it as a temporary task holding area. Put all your sudden thoughts, to-dos, or things you're not sure how to handle yet into the inbox. The goal of the inbox is simple. Clear your mind. Stop stressing over, "I need to remember this," and free up mental space to think and act. Now let's move on to step two, adding lists and organizing tasks. A list means a category. So how do we categorize the items we just collected? In today's video, we'll divide them into three main categories. First is tasks, things that only take one or a few steps to complete, like pay credit card bill, plan feature launch, or attend music festival. Second, projects, things that need multiple steps to finish, like bathroom renovation. And third, habits, things that need to be repeated regularly, like exercise. Now, tap the plus sign to add a list. For tasks, let's create three lists to manage them: next action, waiting, and someday. Enter the list name, then click the hamburger icon to set the list icon. The next action list is for tasks with deadlines that need to be done soon, like pay credit card bill or reply customer messages. Select these tasks from the inbox and move them to the next action list. Next, add the waiting list. After adding, you can press and drag it to reorder. The waiting list is for tasks you've delegated to someone else and are waiting for a response. For example, I'm waiting for a team member to finish the new feature launch plan, so I'll move that to the waiting list. Next, add the someday list. The someday list is for tasks that don't have a specific due date, like things to try sometime in the future. For example, here, we can move attend music festival to this list. Next, let's handle projects. Projects are long-term, complex items, so creating a single task won't work for these. Instead, let's create the bathroom renovation project as a list. Follow the same steps as before. In practice, you'll probably have more than one project. So let's create a folder to organize all your projects and keep everything neat. Similarly, you can drag the folder to reorder it and set an emoji for it. Then right-click the folder, select Add List, and add other project lists inside. Once the project lists are created, you can add the tasks related to each project to their corresponding list for better organization. Lastly, habits are key too. Things like exercise or eat fruit require regular effort, so use the habit tracker to manage them. It gives you more detailed stats than simply setting a task with a repeat function. Switch to the habit tracker, tap the plus sign in the top right to create a habit. Set the name, frequency, goal, and reminder, then hit OK. Now, let's go back to the inbox and remove the items that have been added as projects and habits. Your lists are already categorized, but if you feel you need more organization, you can create tags. Of course, if the list categories are enough, you don't need tags. For example, categorize tasks by area: work, personal, relationships, finances, and so on. Click the plus icon to create a tag, enter the tag name, and choose its color. Why set a color? Stay tuned to find out. Then add the corresponding tags to your tasks. You can right-click a task to add a tag, or drag the task onto the desired tag to add it. Now you'll see the tags in your tasks, making it easier to sort them. A quick note, there are lots of ways to categorize, not just by area. For instance, if you prefer to sort by location, you can create tags like office, supermarket, home, etc. This way, when you're in a particular location, you can quickly find tasks related to that space, saving time. The last step is setting task priorities and scheduling. First, based on urgency, Click the flag icon to set a priority for each task, ensuring high-priority tasks are handled first. Next, schedule your tasks. How? Switch to the calendar and pick the view you need. TickTick offers a lot of view options. If you want to focus on each day and manage the duration of every task, you can choose the day view. If you just want a week's plan, you can choose the week view. For long-term planning, go with the month view. Right-click on the calendar icon and select Show Tasks to drag tasks from your list into the calendar to quickly set dates or times. On mobile, tap the three dots button in the top right of the calendar and choose Arrange Tasks to quickly set task dates. At this point, the role of tag colors comes into play. You might notice that the task colors in the calendar follow the color of their tags. Click the top right three dots, View Options, Find Color, and you'll see it set to display by tag color. You can also set list colors and choose to display by list color. Pick to display tasks based on their list or tag colors so it's easy to distinguish them. Once you've scheduled everything, it's time for the final step. Start working on your tasks as per the schedule. In just four simple steps, you've built a clear, efficient task management system. Now, whether it's work tasks or personal stuff, you can handle everything smoothly. If you like this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with anyone who might find it helpful. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.